Next on Woodsongs, it's an entire hour with one of the most legendary guitarists on planet Earth. It's Tommy Emmanuel.
Television broadcast of the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour is presented in part by the Martin Guitar Company, making handcrafted guitars since 1833, online at martinguitar.com. The Lexington Convention and Visitors Bureau, providing information to visit Lexington, Kentucky, online at visitlex.com. By Folkbook, a social media site for arts and music, online at folk-book.com. And by Time Warner Cable, providing cable, telephone, and internet service.
Here on the Louisiana Hayride, his name is Hank Williams. The best
from the Grand Ole Opry,
Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys.
Hi, this is Bruce Hornsby.
Hi, this is Kevin Moe.
Hey, folks, this is Bela Fleck.
Hi, folks, this is Sam Bush.
Hello, this is Odetta.
This is Joan Baez, and you're listening to the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour.
And now, gather the family around and sit back in your easy chair. It's time again for the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour, our worldwide celebration of grassroots music. Let's welcome folk singer, author, and tree hugger, Michael Jonathan.
Here's a song that you'll rarely hear on a banjo. It's an aria from a wonderful opera called Porgy and Bess. Summertime, when the living is easy, the fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, your mom is good looking. So hush, little baby, now, don't you cry. One of these mornings you're gonna rise up singing, and you'll spread your wings and learn to fly. But come that morning, nobody will harm you, 'cause mama and daddy are passing by. Instrumental time. Get the audience to sing with Melissa. Ready? All together. Here we go.
Summertime, and the living is easy. The fish are jumping, and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mom's good looking. So hush, little baby.
You guys sound so good. Let's let you do it just by yourselves. Ready? Just the audience. Here we go.
Summertime. And the living is easy. So hush, little baby, now, don't you cry.
And welcome to the historic Lyric Theater. Here we are in our beautiful hometown of Lexington, Kentucky, the crossroads of America's folk and bluegrass music. It's the gateway city to the magnificent Appalachian Mountains, where so much of this amazing music and art comes from. And on this stage, we celebrate the world of grassroots music like it was a precious diamond of many facets. And these facets are folk and blues and bluegrass. It's country, Celtic, old-timey, new singer, songwriter. Sometimes it's rock and roll. Sometimes it's classical, even opera that we've had on this stage, because we love it all. We enjoy it all, we celebrate it all, just like you, our audience, does. Artists come from everywhere to be here. You don't have to be famous to be on Woodsongs. You just have to be very, very good. He's been on our show 6 times already, and each time brought something amazing and special, so we've invited him back again for the entire hour. His story started over 50 years ago as a little boy listening to the washing machine go round and round, and his mom teaching him how to play. And when he was about 6 years old, his father decided, wow, my kids are so talented, they started a family band, and they sold their home, and they started living in station wagons and touring around the country. His father passed away, and about that time, he heard on the radio this song in 1961 by the amazing guitarist Chet Atkins. Listen to this music. There was something about the guitar, something about what was happening on that record, that Chet Atkins moved this little 6-year-old, 7-year-old boy. And it turned into an entire career. He's toured all over around the world. Guitar Player magazine, twice the readers have voted him best acoustic guitarist by readers. He's one of the most admired and revered guitar players in the entire world. We're going to dip into a CD of his called Endless Road. This is the Chet Atkins song that moved him when he was 7 years old. Now he's going to play it for you. It's Windy and Warm. Please welcome Tommy Emmanuel to the Woodsongs Old Time Radio.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
From the CD, Endless Road, Windy and Warm, Tommy Emmanuel. Welcome back to the show,
well,
man.
Well, thanks for having me, Michael.
So I want the audience to know that they can go backwards on the Woodsongs archives. We've talked about your history, your mom and dad, your brother.
Yeah.
Get a pencil, because in a minute I'm going to tell the audience the number of the broadcast that he was on, so you can go back and learn this fascinating history. But
you could torture yourself even more.
That's right. We're going to devote this hour to your guitar. To your left hand, to your right hand, what you're doing, why you're doing it, and how you learned it.
Okay? Well, that's a very brave move of you. Thank you very much.
Sort of a global guitar lesson by a master, Tommy Emmanuel. So. Wow. I think the audience is going to love it. 50 years ago, you're 7 years old, you turn on the radio, there's a lot going on in your personal life at the time.
Yeah. Well, actually, prior to that, I was... playing, I started out as a musician playing with my mother, and because she was interested in Hawaiian music and she needed a rhythm player. Mm-hmm. And then once I started playing the rhythm guitar, my brother Phil wanted to play lead, and then my eldest brother took up drums. My sister played as well. But what was interesting was that we weren't really that aware of a bass player on the records, because I was trying to cover the bass part. I'll show you what I mean. Some of the records we listened to, for instance, the bass part went like this. And the rhythm player went like this. But what I was hearing was this. So it was a happy accident.
So because you... Because you, as a little kid, you were not really aware of what a bass player was. Yes. You're listening to the records, you're hearing the bass, but you're assuming it's the guitar.
I'm assuming it's the rhythm player, yeah. Right. And that's why I call that a happy accident. Because mm-hmm. when I heard Chet on the radio going like that and then playing the melody on top of it, I could hear that he was doing everything at once, mm-hmm. and everybody tried to talk me out of that. Everybody said, no, 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 it's a recording trick. You can't do that.
Right.
And I said, well, I could hear it, and so I just kept working on it. And I started out with a straight pick, and then eventually, by the time I was about 10, I saw a photo of Chet for the first time, and he was wearing a thumb pick.
Thumb pick. So now you play with a thumb, but no finger picks, just the thumb pick.
No finger picks, no, just the flesh. And I can flat pick with a thumb pick, and I can finger pick with a flat pick. I can swap around.
Isn't it nice that when you were a little kid, you were wise enough not to listen to the critics? I mean, look
I've never listened to critics. Well. What the hell do they know?
Isn't it... Sibelius said, which was just brilliant a couple centuries ago, he said, fear not the critics, for no one has ever erected a statue in honor of one.
Exactly. Thank you very much.
So exactly. We're going to go into a song that demonstrates this bass playing process while you're playing the melody.
Once I started learning some of these tunes by Chet Atkins and Merle Travers, a fellow Kentuckian, by the way. Mm-hmm. Once I started playing in that style, I was kind of hungry to do something different and more exciting. So I found a way of being able to swing the bass around, move the bass like a bass player would. So I was sitting down one day trying to play the song Blue Moon, and I was going... Right? You know how the tune goes. And this
saxophone... See, no, that sounds good enough.
Oh, no. It's going to get better. Lucky for me, see, I was living in a house with two other musicians who were both jazz guys, and I wasn't a jazz guy. But they heard me playing that, and one of them said, why don't you move the bass through the changes? And what that means is, why don't you spell out the chords by moving the bass around? Mm-hmm. So I started going, blue moon.
Getting a little jazz on that.
See that? And then the bass moved around. And then I found some little harmonies in the bridge. Then, there's... See that? I started moving harmonies around.
All right, so let's give you a chance now to play the audience this song in its entirety.
Yeah.
And I want them to listen for the parts that you just demonstrated. From his CD, Dare to Be Different, the song is Blue Moon, Tommy Emmanuel, and one single guitar.
So there's the bass. Here's the drums. And then I got a rhythm guy as well. Here he is. Think of the money I'm saving up here, ladies and gentlemen. And Mr. Fabulous, the lead player, here he comes. Thanks, Chet. Thank you.
From the CD, Dare to Be Different. One man and one single guitar. The song Blue Moon. If you want to know more about Tommy Emmanuel and this particular show, just visit woodsongs.com. Click on the archive page. This is show number 731. And what's that sound? Oh, that's the sound of guitar players all over the world putting their guitar in their cases and throwing them in the closet after they heard that.
I hope not.
So you're playing the lead, you're playing the rhythm, you're playing jazz, you're playing bass runs. Is there anything else possibly you could add to an instrumental song?
With a guitar like this, this acoustic guitar has an electronic system inside. It also has a microphone inside. And so the microphone picks up the sound of the box, basically. The guitar is a box with another piece of wood coming out of it, right? So you've got... got all sorts of sounds coming off the thing. So I actually use the guitar like a percussive instrument.
So what you were just doing with the guitar in your world was not good enough. You thought, let me beat on it while I'm playing it.
No, actually, you know, I'm actually a drummer.
Didn't you play drums with your family band?
I've played drums on a lot of things.
So percussion is part of your musical nature?
Yeah. Bass, drums, and guitar, they're my three instruments. Mm-hmm. I started banging on the guitar.
See, you are banging.
Yeah, I'm banging on it. I started banging on it back in the 70s when we first put electronics in acoustic guitars.
So the pickup allows the percussive sound to punch through.
Yeah, you can go, you know, and people can hear it. So and if you just want to use your pick, you can get it. Or you can get... those kind of sounds, or you can get, or you know, whatever you wish. You can. And I also.
Any more toys you could throw in the mix?
Well, yeah. I use a drummer's brush. Yeah. And people often ask me, you know, why do you do all this stuff? Well,
to show
nobody
off.
Else does. I'm trying to do something different.
Yeah. Well, now. Did it, when you were first starting it, I mean, was it something that you added naturally, or is it something you specifically said, I want to try to work this in, and you had to, like, really practice it?
No, what happened was, I was doing a show with my brother, and my brother Phil, mm-hmm. and he was playing...
Who is a spectacular guitar player.
Oh, he really is.
He's wonderful.
I was doing a show with my brother, and we had built the crowd. They were frothing at the mouth, I can tell you. And we were reaching the kind of crescendo point of the show, and he broke a string on his guitar. He's playing what we call a Fender Stratocaster. And if you break a string on a Fender Stratocaster, because it has this mechanism inside it with springs and relies on pressure, everything goes out of tune real badly. So he breaks the string at this point and turns to me and says, take it. And I'm playing an acoustic guitar plugged into the sound system. And I'm going, you know, take what? Like that. And he just walks off to change his string. So I'm left there, you know, like a stranded goose. And this situation was pretty ludicrous, so I start banging on the guitar. I start going... and all that stuff, and the crowd start going crazy like this.
Just like that, yeah.
Well, not that good. The audience in Australia weren't that good. No,
well, let's do this. Now that we've set up the idea of percussion on the guitar mm-hmm. while you're playing melody and bass and chords and stuff.
Well, I play the song, right? And mm-hmm. then I go into a percussion solo, which ends with people going really crazy and standing up and clapping and stuff like that. Well.
Please don't cede the audience reaction by any means. From his CD only, it's Mombasa, it's Tommy Emmanuel on the Woodsongs, Old Time Radio. Thank you.
Thank you.
Tommy Emmanuel and his guitar and his hands and his brush and a brush. And let's talk about the care of your hands as a guitar player.
Uh-huh.
Seriously, the care of your hands. I mean, you make your living with this, and
there are certain things I don't do. You know, like I used to love playing tennis, mm-hmm. but that was hard on my forearms and really affected my finger picking. So I had to stop that.
Did you ever have problems like numbness in your fingers and stuff like that?
I've been very fortunate all my life, and I think I'm pretty right in saying that if you have like a repetitive stress with your hands, or you have problems, RSI and all that stuff, I think you're probably doing something wrong, mm-hmm. you know, because you should be able to play the guitar all day and all night and not have a problem with your hands. So I've been very
fortunate.
You
probably end up with a problem
way.
With your girlfriend or wife.
Well, that's for sure. You've got to, everything's a delicate balance.
It's a balance, that's right. What kind of guitar are you playing right now?
This is a Maton guitar made in Melbourne, Australia.
Okay, and the kind of strings you're using?
These ones are Martin strings, Martin FX.
Straight out of the box?
Straight out of the box. Put them on. I change them every show.
At medium or light gauge?
These are light gauge, 12 to 54. And these two over here have mediums on.
Right. Do you set the action on the strings closer to the fret than normal, or do you just leave it?
No, not the normal. I get the neck very straight, and then I get the action set how I like it, mm-hmm. By very professional people. And I just carry a tool with me on the road, and with the different... weather,
climate,
you know,
changes,
climate
the way
changes, it changes, and all that. Yeah, the wood can move because you know it's wood; it's alive.
I'm going to cut in here. Tommy's got a wonderful CD. If you like what he's doing on the stage by himself, he's got a CD of just him on a stage in a theater. It's called Live and Solo in Pensacola. And let's cut in and do a final song for a couple minutes here at the end of the half hour. It's El Vaquero, Tommy Emmanuel, on the Wood Songs. Old time radio.
Thank you so very much.
It's from his CD, Live and Solo in Pensacola, an entire album with just him on stage in a wonderful theater, just like here at the Lyric Theater. We are broadcasting an entire hour with the great Tommy Emmanuel. It's a wonderful guitar lesson that's going out worldwide. Stay where you are in the second half hour. We've got yet more conversation and an actual guitar lesson, so we'll be back right after this.
Hi, this is Leo Kottke, and you're listening to Michael Jonathan, Woodsongs, Old Time Radio Hour.
Yeah, there's another good guitar player. Leo Kottke, good buddy. Welcome to the broadcast coming from the historic Lyric Theater here in our hometown of Lexington, Kentucky, broadcasting worldwide on over 509 radio stations. Let's say hello to the big, huge radio audience that's out there. From our audience here, the Lyric Theater. We're also broadcasting around the world on American Forces Radio Network, 173 nations plus, every military base, every single U.S. naval ship worldwide. And as usual, we want to say hello to all the men and women out there that work so hard. Woodsongs is also a TV series. You get to watch a radio show in progress on your hometown public television station. We're in over 90 million homes nationwide on public television and online. We get a lot of email from our listeners. If you want to send me an email, I'd love to hear from you. My email address is simple. It's michael@woodsongs.com. Of course, Tommy Emmanuel is from Australia, living in the States. And there was somebody else in our audience that is also from Australia, living in Nashville, Tennessee. Please say hi to Clara. And you dabble with the guitar a little bit yourself, right?
Yes, I do a little.
Yeah. And your family is mainly from Korea?
Yep, but I was born in Australia.
Yeah. And when did you move to the States?
About 3-4 years ago.
Yeah. And about 3-4 years ago, about 2 weeks ago or so, something really interesting happened in your life.
Yeah, that's right. Tommy and I got married.
So we're talking to Mrs. Tommy Emmanuel, Clara, yeah?
Yes, that's right.
And you realize that there's hundreds of thousands of dude guitarists that would love to be in your shoes in a way, sort of, to be able to be that close to a guitar master like that. So being around the living room couch at night must be interesting. Do you play on the guitar with your husband?
Not actually that often. We've played once on stage in Paris.
That's romantic.
Yep, we did two duets, and I thought I'll just end it on a high, and that was it.
Was that wasn't Paris, Kentucky, or Paris, Texas, was it? It was Paris, France.
France, yeah. So what we wanted, we thought would be nice, since they're newlyweds, and Clara is here tonight, and they're just brand new married, right? We're very, very proud of you, very happy for you. We're going to let you introduce the next song, okay?
Okay. This is Tommy Emmanuel playing the Beatles medley on Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour.
The Beatles medley is performed on our stage.
Beginner's luck.
Not quite. Tommy Emmanuel. Now, in the first half hour, we described the influence that Chet Atkins had on you, mm-hmm. and that as a young boy, you started to really take the guitar very seriously, and your style of playing and stuff because of how Chet Atkins inspired you. We
yes, sir.
Found not too far from our hometown of Lexington, Kentucky, in a town called Richmond, mm-hmm. a young 13-year-old boy, and his hero is Tommy Emmanuel, just like Chet Atkins was to you. So we're gonna introduce him musically first, and then we're gonna have a conversation with him. We're gonna let him, he's here with his guitar, 13 years old. Let's set this up a little bit, Tommy. You're playing in standard tuning.
Yeah, we're we're both playing in standard
Parker,
tuning.
Parker, you're in standard tuning as well.
That's right. Yep.
Okay. Yeah. And what key is this in?
This is in the key of D.
Key of D. And I noticed that in most of your songs, Tommy, you stay in first position chords as much as possible.
Yeah, that's where the money is.
Yeah. Okay. Remember that, Parker.
No. Chet used to always say, don't go up the dusty end. There's no
right.
money up there.
Right.
You know? Stay down here.
So, Parker, the lesson is clear. Listen to Tommy Emmanuel, and you too can make tens and tens of dollars as a guitar player.
Exactly.
Going around the world. Why don't you guys play the song?
You'll always have a pocket full of coins. Yes. Isn't that right? Here we go. Dixie McGuire and Parker will take the melody, and I will fumble my way through the harmonies. Here we go. Off you go. This is unison. Now I'm going to switch to harmony. Thank you. Rebecca Hastings.
I'm Emmanuel.
You'll find that song, Dixie McGuire, on Tommy's wonderful album he did with Chet Atkins, The Day Finger Pickers Took Over the World. Isn't it fun having an artist like Parker Hastings just drop in?
The mayor of Richmond, Kentucky.
Yeah. Sometimes I really, really love this show because of things like that. So it must mean a lot to you. I mean, this is like going full circle 5 decades later.
You're not kidding. It's a beautiful feeling.
And to have him learn one of your songs, all the way out in Richmond, Kentucky, there's a little kid.
I know it. It's unbelievable. There's a little boy in Croatia by the name of Freno, who's a bit younger than Parker. And he goes on stage and plays some of my songs so beautifully. Mm. And he's so concentrated. And again, he's playing because he loves to play. And that's the key. If you take your focus off that, things don't work like they should. If you're chasing fame and money, well, good luck to you. But you're never going to get there if you don't stay true to the gift of music and share it with everybody.
Well said. And I want to encourage the audience to really explore the world of Tommy Emmanuel, his guitar, his family history, what brought him here. I mean, the things that we didn't talk about, the things that he struggles with, is very, very inspiring that he's able to do what he's doing. If you go to woodsongs.com, click on the archive page. This is show 731. You get to watch this show again, if you like. But you can go back, way back in the early days, he did show 245. Then he came back and did show 349. Then he came back again and did 428. Then he came back and did show 548. Then he came back and did show 562. Then he came back with his brother Phil and did show 624. So we are dear friends.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me back, Mike.
I love it. Let's end on a wonderful musical note. The hour's already gone by. We're going to go back into this album of you. The album is just you on stage. It is from his CD, Live and Solo in Pensacola. It's the T.E. Ranch on the Woodsongs. Old time.
Thank you.
Wasn't it great having Tommy Emmanuel on the show for the entire hour?
Thank you.
From Richmond, Kentucky, 13-year-old Parker Hastings and his guitar. And wasn't it an honor to meet Tommy's brand new bride, Clara, was here on our stage as well. So. Tommy's right. Passion transcends payment every time. Passion is permanent. It's always there. It's very, very moving. It's the glue that holds this wonderful community together. And we look at the whole hour and all the things that we have not been able to talk about. Tommy gets this punchy guitar sound because he uses an AER acoustic amp, and Parker's using the same kind. He's got a feed buster in his guitar hole. Why is he doing that? What kind of thumb pick is he using? There's so much we haven't talked about that I think we need to invite Tommy Emmanuel back again and continue this conversation. The point is this: great art is never done. There is no end to the wonderment of a magnificent guitar player because it's not just Tommy, it's those that he inspires, whether it's a little kid in Croatia or another young kid in Richmond, Kentucky, or you sitting out there, you who knows three chords in the truth, you who knows how to barely sit on the couch of your living room and play those songs. You know what? What you're doing with your family is just as passionate as what Tommy gets to do all over the world. Don't stop. Keep going. Music, it's an amazing form of love and communication. My name is Michael Jonathan. I'm a folk singer. I am a log cabin dweller. And we'll see you next week on the Woodsongs Old Time Radio.
To Woodsongs broadcast number 731. Michael's opening song was Summertime from the Porgy and Bess Opera.
Thank you for tuning in. There are so many talented artists that appear on our stage. It's very hard sometimes to pick the ones that appear on our TV broadcast. So what we're going to do is leave you with a performance from our huge online archive of past shows. We'll see you next time on the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour. Hey, it's Phil Emmanuel on the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour.
Thank you.
Closed captioning provided by the Deering Banjo Company. The television broadcast of the Woodsongs Old Time Radio Hour is presented in part by the Martin Guitar Company, making handcrafted guitars since 1833, online at martinguitar.com. The Lexington Convention and Visitors Bureau, providing information to visit Lexington, Kentucky, online at visitlex.com. By Folkbook, a social media site for arts and music, online at folk-book.com. And by Time Warner Cable, providing cable, telephone, and internet service.